Tusa Somani, and I am the leader of Elemental Expedition Outreach Program here at Salt Lake Community College. I'm going to have a 15-minute presentation and then 3 minutes for question and answer. I'm going to start with a little bit of history. So for the past 15 years, Elemental Expedition, our outreach program, has made greatest strides toward broadening the educational opportunities available for local elementary schools in amphitheater settings and in classroom settings. So for the past 2 years, we have incorporated pre and post quizzes in our presentations in order to see if students are changing anything and absorbing anything from our presentation or not. So our quiz had 3 questions. The first 2 questions are non-factual. That means that we didn't talk about it during our presentations. But the last one is a factual question. That means that we talked about it during our presentation. So I'm going ahead and show you the questions. So the first question is asking that, who do you think is a scientist? We are targeting their biases. We are showing them 12 pictures of adults from different genders and ethnicities and different careers. And we are asking them, who do you think is a scientist? And this was a non-factual question. And they were answering our question by circling yes or no under the on the bottom of the pictures. So question 2 is again targeting their biases and is asking, who do you think can grow up to be a scientist? We have 12 different children with a different clothing and genders, and we are asking them, well, who do you think is can grow up to be a scientist? This was a non-factual question as well. For question 3, we have a we have 12 objects, and we are asking them which of these are made up of chemicals. During our presentation, we were talking about this. During our presentation, we were telling them, oh, everything is made up of chemicals, but it wasn't the point of our presentation. I'm going to talk about it more when we get to analysis. It was a factual question, yeah. So I'm sure most of you have heard the Sigma or the stereotype that men are better at science and women are better suited for liberal arts. After taking the Harvard implicit bias test, I got this graph, and the most interesting sad part of this graph is this. Only 1% of people who were taking this test had a strong association between female with science, only 1%. So what was our goal? What did we want to do when we were going to these schools and doing this presentation? Did we want to change this stigma? No, we didn't want. We had a lot of better goals. I'm going to talk about it after introducing to you my great team and the fabulous experiments we did for these children. It has sound. we were going to different school. We reached out to more than 1,000 students. So our goal, so for these past 15 years, we had two basic goals. The first one was that we wanted to instill the fact that anyone children are associating with is a scientist, can be a scientist, and everyone can grow up to be a scientist. Everyone. It means like it doesn't matter who your parents are and what background you're coming from, you can grow up to be a scientist. And as a leader, well, I had my own goal too. So I wanted to decrease the gap between genders. So before the presentation, we were giving them the pre-quizzes several days before the presentation. And then after the presentation, several days after the presentation, we were giving them the post-quizzes. They didn't know that it's related to our program. So just for control. So after that, we have 1,108 pre-quizzes and 1,108 pre-quizzes and 1,108 post-quizzes. It was a lot. So we gathered together with my team members, and well, I gave half of them to some of my team members. They spread it out into their trunk. We had an umbrella on top of it. We let the rain fall. We designed a new experiment, and we only counted the circles which didn't fade away after the rain. Also, the rest of them, I gave them to the other team members who had pool table in their house. And we shot cue balls in it, and we only counted the quizzes which the cue balls landed on. Yeah, just kidding. We entered everything into a cell. And so as you can see, we have entered every picture separately for more precise analysis. So for analyzing data, we calculated the percentage change and difference between males and females pre and post quiz, and pre and post quiz, pre and pre quizzes of females vs pre quizzes of males, and post quizzes of females versus post quizzes of males. And also we have paired a two-tailed t-test, and the p-values we considered they're statistically significant when they're smaller than 0.05, and they're statistically not significant if they are bigger than 0.05. This is the results that we got from question one. Again, I'm reminding you of the question, who do you think is a scientist, is the question. So as you can see, we have growth, and if we have decrease, the decrease are not significant. We had only one significant decrease from pre to post quiz, and it was this one for both genders. We had a decrease, and for this African American scientist looking woman, we had decrease. So decrease is not ideal in this situation, and it goes back to the design of the quiz. So our assumption is that when the children are looking at a page like with multiple questions, they tend to think it's wrong to answer yes, same answer for all of the pictures on the same page. So they probably decrease their answer, but it's a good sign at the same time too. Why? Because at first they were so biased, that they thought, oh, this person looks like a scientist, I should say yes and no to the other people. But after a presentation, they realized that doctors can be scientists too. They realized engineers can be scientists too. We had in the movie I showed you, one of our team members was using headscarf. They realized that a person with headscarf can be scientists too. So they reduced their bias and gave it to the other people. So we have same pattern in question two. We had increase in most of them, but here we had a decrease, significant decrease for both females and males, and the person is looking again like a scientist. And here, for this girl, we had decrease, significant decrease for both genders, and she looks like a scientist. Also, we had significant decrease only for females here, and she has glasses on, and here, we had only significant decrease for females and she has glasses on. Again, this is another assumption. We need a lot of more studies about it, but we, so in the movie I showed you that we didn't have glasses at all. So probably we think girls are more thinking that like they like role models better than boys, but this is just assumption. We need more studies. But for question three, which was our only factual question, we had All of them had growth, but only we had one decrease there. It wasn't significant, but I just wanted to show you that we had all increases. So for this is the graph that I'm adding up all the questions together. So I'm looking at the page one, which was question one, who do you think is a scientist? And then question two, which was who can grow up to be a scientist? And question three, which was which of these are made up of chemicals? As you can see, all of them had growth. So females had a significant growth in question one and question three, not in question two, but males had significant growth in all of the three categories. So females had significant growth overall in the quiz, and males had significant growth overall in the quiz. I want to point out that the females' score was higher in question one and question two, which were non-factual questions, and males' score was higher in the factual question. So this graph shows the average scores. I calculated the scores for each gender in every question. The thing that was really exciting in this graph is that even though the last score on the post quiz of female was higher than males, but the percentage increase of males was higher than females, that means that males had absorbed more out of our presentation. So let's go back to our goal. So I told you that I wanted to decrease the gap between genders by our presentation. This is a table that I have calculated the p-values between the pre-quizzes of females versus the pre-quizzes of males, and then post-quizzes of females versus post-quizzes of males. At first, the p-value, the overall quiz gap between genders was very significant. I want to point out this question too here. We have a significant gap between genders in question two before our presentation, but we have a not significant gap between genders after the presentation, and that resulted into the overall gap between genders to not be significant anymore. And that means that we did a really good job by our presentations. So for future work, we will change the experiments a little bit. We are going to add animations and toys and other stuff to it. And so we are, because we want to increase the female students' understanding of factual concepts and male students' understanding of non-factual concepts. And I want to thank Salta Community College Chemistry Department for their funding. Thank you so much, and especially my direct supervisors, Professor Walkars and Alvarez, for helping me through this research, and also all the other students. We had a lot of people working on this program, and thank you all these people, and also Professor Olya Mao for conducting a statistical analysis and enhancement of this research, and the music that didn't play. Thank you so much. I can answer the questions. Yes.
So is this the Salt Lake Community College program?
Yes.
How is it funded? Are you just doing it on
your own? The chemistry department funded it. We had $700 funding. It was really, well, it should be more for next year. So we had to, well, we printed the quizzes by the funding of chemistry department, but we mostly bought the experiment and presentation and things ourselves. But I hope next year we get more funding. Yeah. Yeah. Any other question? Was that answering your question?
It is.
Okay.
I'm not a statistician. What is the p-value?
Oh, the p-value, when we pair a two-tailed t-test, so there is a one-tailed t-test and there is two-tailed t-test. One-tailed t-test only looks at one end of the normal bell-shaped graph, but two-tailed looks at two tails of the graph. So the p-value is showing that when it's small, it means that there was no connection and a similarity between the two categories that I'm looking at. But if it's bigger than 0.05, it means that there was connection, they were related, or maybe if there is difference, the difference is accidental.